So in the last class we have solved two examples on AC parallel circuits. We will continue with the same numericals today and we will end up this. Okay. So a circuit is given having an inductive coil of power factor 0.8 inductive coil of power factor 0.8 in series with a capacitor of 100 microfarad. connected to a 50 hertz supply. If the drop across impedance, if the voltage drop across impedance is equal to the voltage across capacitance, if the voltage drop across impedance is equal to the voltage across capacitance, find the values of R and L. Find the values of R and L. So this is connected across a supply of 50 hertz. The value of voltage is not given. It is connected across the supply of 50 hertz. Now I have an inductive coil of power factor 0.8. So cos phi of this is 0.8. Okay. And if the voltage across ZL and capacitor is same, then I need to find what is the value of the R and L of this coil. Okay. Because it is series circuit, both the components will get the same current. Okay. So given power factor of coil is equals to 0.8 and VL is equals to VC. Power factor of coil is 0.8 and VL is equals to VC. What is VL? I can write VL is equals to I into XL. Okay. Sorry. Not XL. I into ZL is equals to I into XC. Because it is a pure capacitor, it doesn't have any resistance in series with it. So it will be VC is equals to I into XC. Since both are connected in series, my currents will be same. I can write ZL is equals to XC. And I know the value of C, so I can get the value of XC. Okay. Therefore, XC is equals to 1 over 2 pi FC. Okay. So 1 over 2 pi into 50 into 100 micro. So this is equals to, I don't have the value here. It's 31.83. XC will come out to be 31.83. Therefore, ZL is equals to 31.83. because ZL equals to XC. ZL is equals to 31.83. Okay. And we know cos phi is equals to 0.8. I can write this equals to R by ZL. Okay. Therefore, R is equals to ZL into 0.8. So that is 31.83 into 0.8. It's 25.46. So I know R, I know ZL, I can get XL. Okay. And ZL is equals to under root R square plus XL square. Or XL is equals to under root ZL square minus R square. So this will come out. So R is 25.46 ohms, XL is 19.1 ohms. So from XL I can get the value of L. So XL equals to 2 pi FL or L is equals to XL upon 2 pi F. So this is 19.1 upon 2 pi into 50. So it will come out. .0607 henries. So this is the value of L. So once I know the power factor and impedance of any coil, I can very conveniently calculate the value of the resistance and inductance. Okay. We'll take one more numerical. For the circuit shown, for the circuit shown, find the current in each branch and total current. For the circuit shown, find the current in each branch and total current, power factor of the circuit, power factor of the circuit and power consumed by the circuit. So the voltage here is having some phase angle. The initial phase angle of voltage is not zero here. Okay. So we need to consider the angle of voltage also in my calculation. So the total current of the circuit be I. Current in RL branch be I1. Current in RC branch be I2. Now here I can write I1 is equals to E by Z1 and I2 is equals to E by Z2, where Z1 is equals to, it is an RL branch, so 10 ohm is resistance, 18 ohm is reactance. Okay, directly the reactance values are given, it will be 10 plus J18, because it is inductive branch, therefore I have to take plus J. And Z2 is equals to, it is 12 minus J23 ohms. Okay. I can substitute the values of Z1, E, okay, in I1. So therefore I1 will be equals to, E is 220 at an angle 15 divided by Z1 is 10 plus J18. This will be equals to. So directly I can substitute this complex ratio into the calculator. Keep the calculator in complex mode. So 220 at an angle plus 15. Okay, angle is there in the upper keypad for minus sign. You can use it with shift function. So 220 at an angle 15 divided by divided by 10 plus 18i is equals to, I get 7.43 minus J 7.67 amperes. Okay. So converting it into polar form, 10.68 at an angle minus 45.94 or at an angle minus 46 degrees amperes. Okay, so this is I1. Similarly, I2, 220 at an angle 15 divided by 12 minus J23 so 1.84 plus J 8.27. amperes. Converting it into polar, 8.48 at an angle plus 77.44 amperes. Okay. So this is my second branch current. Okay. Now I need to find the total current I. So total current I is equals to I1 plus I2. So you can add polar forms or you can add rectangular forms. Okay, so you will get the same thing. Okay. So I1 plus I2 is 9.26 plus J 0.59 or I is equals to 9.28 at an angle 3.67. At an angle 3.67. So in the previous cases what we did to calculate the power factor, I directly took the angle of current in cos phi. But here I can't do that. Why? Because the voltage is also having some phase angle. Initial phase angle of voltage is 15 degrees. So this voltage of 220 volts RMS is not starting at omega t equal to 0, but instead it is starting at omega t equals to 15 degrees. Whereas current is starting at omega t is equals to 3.67 degrees. So that is the phase angle of the current. Okay. So to calculate the power factor, okay, I need a phase angle between voltage and current. Okay, I need phase angle between voltage and current such that the phase angle is resultant of these two phase angles. Okay. Power factor is equals to cos phi. Now where phi is, okay, angle between voltage and current. Angle between voltage and current. That is phi is equals to phase angle of voltage minus phase angle of current. So this phi is equals to phase angle of voltage is 15 minus phase angle of current is 3.67. So this now phi is equals to 15 minus 3.67, 11.33 degrees. Therefore, cos phi is equal to cos of 11.33 degrees. Which is equals to 0.98. So now whether this cos 5.98, yeah, cos phi is 0.98, which is the angle difference between cos of angle difference between voltage and current. So what does this mean is, the angle between voltage and current, now say if I mark the vectors of voltage and current, voltage vector E is residing at an angle 15 degrees, voltage vector I is residing at an angle 3.67 degrees. Now this is the angle difference between E and I, phi. Okay, and see here, we see that voltage is at 15 degrees, current is at 3 degrees. Okay, and these vectors are rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, these vectors are rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So, voltage is leading the current by an angle 11.33 degrees. Therefore, the power factor will be lagging. The current is lagging behind the voltage. If the angle of current would have been greater than 15 degrees, then the current would be leading the voltage by some angle, that angle difference. But when you see the angle phase, initial phase angle of the current, okay, it is at 3.67 degrees. Okay. Therefore, this current I, total current I, is lagging behind E by an angle 15 minus 3.67, that is 11.33 degrees. Okay, so this is how we have to understand the circuits. If the voltage of phase angle of voltage is 0, it is very simple. Okay, when there is phase angle of voltage given in the example, then whether the power factor is leading or lagging, it is very easily can be decided just by plotting the vectors with respect to their angle positions. The moment you plot the vectors with respect to their angular positions, we will get to know which is leading and which is lagging. Okay. So in this case, current is lagging behind the voltage by an angle 11.33 degrees. Okay. Now, whether this is right or wrong, in one of the previous class we have discussed that in parallel circuit, in series circuit, if XC is greater than XL, then the circuit behaves capacitive. But whereas in parallel circuit, if XC is greater than XL, the circuit behaves inductive. See, XC is 23 ohms, XL is 18 ohms. Therefore, in parallel circuit, whichever reactance is less, the circuit behavior is of that nature. The circuit behavior is inductive. So, in inductive circuit, current has to lag. Okay? Therefore, current is lagging behind the voltage by an angle 11.33 degrees. Okay? So, this is the understanding. Now, therefore, power consumed. Power consumed. P is equals to EI cos phi. Is equals to, again please remember, while substituting the value of voltage and current, we should substitute only the magnitudes, not the angles or nor in the complex form. Okay, so magnitude of E is 220 into magnitude of I, the total current I, how much was it? 9.28 into cos phi is 0.98. So P is equals to 2 kilowatt, 2000.768, 2 kilowatt. Okay. So this is how we should be calculating the currents or power factors when the phase angles of voltages are also given. Okay, so this is one example. One more numerical we will take. In an AC circuit, in an AC circuit, in an AC circuit, the maximum value of voltage in an AC circuit, the maximum value of voltage is 150 volts. In an AC circuit, the maximum value of voltage is 150 volts and maximum value of current is 12 amperes. Okay. In an AC circuit, the maximum value of voltage is 150 volts and maximum value of current is 12 amperes. Okay. If the voltage and current If the voltage and current at omega t is equals to 0, if voltage and current at omega t is equals to 0 are 110 volts and 8 amperes respectively, if voltage and current at omega t equal to 0 are 110 volts and 8 amperes respectively, then write the instantaneous equations, and find voltage and current at t is equals to 0.1 seconds. And find voltage and current at t is equals to 0.1 seconds. If the frequency of supply is 60 Hertz. If the frequency of supply is 60 Hertz. So this is the given statement. We are given with the maximum values of voltage and current, and also we are given with the instantaneous values of voltage and current at omega t equal to 0. Okay. So if the value of voltage or current or voltage and current at omega t equal to 0 is 0, then the initial phase angle of voltage and current is 0. Okay. If the value of voltage at omega t equal to 0 is 0, then the initial phase angle of that voltage is 0. If the value of current at omega t equal to 0 is 0, then initial phase angle of that current is also 0. But here we observe, at omega t equal to 0, both voltage and current are having some values which are non-zero. Therefore, both voltage and current are having some initial phase angle. Okay? Both voltage and current are having some initial phase angle. Okay? So therefore, in general, instantaneous equation are E is equals to Em sin omega t plus phi 1 E is equals to sin omega t plus phi 1 and I am sin omega t plus phi 2. Okay. Sin omega t plus phi 2. Okay. So at omega t equal to 0, I have this E is equal to 110 volts. At omega t equal to 0, I have this I equal to 8 amperes. So by putting omega t equal to 0 and substituting E is equal to 110 volts, I will get phi 1. By putting omega t equal to 0 and substituting this I is equal to 8 amperes, I will get angle phi 2. Because Em and Im I know. Okay. Therefore, at omega t is equal to 0, okay, 110 is equals to 150 sine of 0 plus phi 1. Okay. Therefore, phi 1 is equals to sine inverse 110 upon 150. This is phi 1. And this comes out to be 47.16 degrees. Similarly, okay, for current, 8 amperes is equals to 12 sine of 0 plus phi 2, or phi 2 is equals to sine inverse of 8 divided by 12. It is 41.81 degrees. Okay. 41.81 degrees. Therefore, E is equals to 150 sine of omega t plus 47.16, and I is equals to 12 sine of omega t plus 41.81. So it is evident that current is lagging behind the voltage, because the initial phase angle of voltage is greater than the initial phase angle of current. Now, second case is to find the value of E and I at t equal to 0.1 seconds. See, once I know the instantaneous equations, I can conveniently calculate the value of voltages and current at any instant of time. So therefore here, E is equals to at t is equals to 0.1 seconds. So 150 sine of 2 pi f into or omega into 0.1 plus 47.16, and omega is 2 pi f. 150 sine of 2 pi f into 0.1 plus 47.16. The supply frequency is given as 50 hertz. So 2 into 50 is 100. 100 into pi is 314. So 150 sine of 314 into, sorry, supply frequency is 60 hertz. Okay. So 60 in the sense 120 into pi. This 377 into 0.1 plus 47.16. So this will be equals to 150 into sine of 37.7 plus 47.16. T is 149.39 volts, and I is equals to 12 sine of 377 into 0.1 plus 41.81. So this will be 11.8 amperes. So these are the values of current and voltage for the given value of time. You can calculate current and voltage at any time. You can take t is equals to 0.001 seconds, t equal to 0.05 seconds, t equal to, you can take 100 seconds, t equal to, you can take any value. Any value you can substitute the for the value of t and calculate, because this current and voltages are sinusoidal in nature and these are periodic in nature. Okay, so the values will repeat. Okay, so this is about the single phase AC circuits. Okay, here I will end with these 5 different kinds of examples. Okay, so what I will be doing, I will solve on my, sorry, I will solve some other examples, and I will share those solutions with you directly. You please go through the numericals, and wherever necessary I will be writing the comments in those solutions. Please go through those comments also. Okay, so because of time restriction, space restriction, there will be slight difficulty we face in covering the things. These may not be as accurate as we do in our classrooms. Okay, so expectation will be same, that the things should go as the things will go in the classroom. Okay, so because of no two-way interaction between the teaching and learning. Okay, now if I give option for two-way interaction, lot of noise will be there, recording will not be proper, and even if you want to go through these videos in later stages, you will get lot of noise in the recording. So therefore I did not give option for discussion here. So any doubts you face, you please note down those doubts when the class is going on, and you please get back to me with those doubts. I will be clearing those doubts even if individually you want. Okay, so please go through the lecture videos. Even I don't have textbook with me. I asked one of your senior in my department to share the scanned units if they have the textbook, and luckily one student had the basic textbook with her. So I have sent you three phase circuits and single phase circuit chapter content from the textbook directly. Now you don't have any problem in study. Okay, at least you have some resource, you have lecture notes, you can practice the numericals given, solved and unsolved. If you get any difficulty, please get back to me. Okay, so today we'll end. Tomorrow at 8:30 again we'll be starting the class, and tomorrow we'll start with three phase circuits. Okay, I hope you marked your attendance in the chat box. Okay, and attendance, this attendance is regular class attendance itself. Okay, so please have concern about this. So thank you, we'll end now.